from the mouth of the Yellow River to the little church on the hill to this beautiful sanctuary today.
Amen.
And the good news is this, that the founding fathers and mothers of New Bethel in the mouth of the river at that little church didn't have no air conditioning.
Right.
And the original New Bethel wasn't any carpet on the floor.
That's right.
And as Gary pointed out, our in-house was in the outhouse. Am I right?
Yeah.
But let me tell you what's special about New Bethel. You're in a beautiful sanctuary. You got carpet on the floor and air-conditioned air and electricity. But guess what? That spirit that was in the original New Bethel is the same spirit that is here today. The good news is, you bought that spirit of loving the Lord from the mouth of the river to the little white church on the hill to right here on Rockland Road, and that is something you ought to celebrate today. And if easy, four walls could talk.
Yeah.
Oh, what a story they would tell. If these four walls could talk, they would tell us that the men and women who founded this great church, wasn't too many PhDs in the audience that day. The men and women who founded this church didn't have very many of any master's degrees sitting in the pew. Probably wasn't even any college degree. I know that 95% of African Americans were illiterate in the 1890s. God knows I know there wasn't any Mercedes and Lexuses parked in the parking lot. But those men and women understood something. They understood that through faith and through hard work and cooperation and love and cooperation, all things are possible. And you better know and I better know that we are sitting in the pew, but the spirits of those forefathers and forefathers are sitting here with us today. They are here. And so this anniversary, this annual event is when we often come together to celebrate a notable event.
Yes.
Birthdays, wedding anniversaries, church anniversaries. But we also celebrate things that are not so notable. We not celebrate, but we commemorate April 4th when Martin Luther King was assassinated.
Yeah.
We don't celebrate, but we commemorate 9/11 when we attacked by terrorists.
Yeah.
So celebrations, anniversaries are important. Because
yeah.
It helps us to think about 12 months that have passed.
Yeah.
As we sit here and celebrate today, we know that many of our fellow church members who were in the pew on last church anniversary didn't quite make it to this anniversary. Am I right? So we celebrate life.
Yeah.
That God has given us the life to what? Be present here today.
Yeah.
We celebrate all the goodness that occurred over the last 12 months that we didn't even deserve, but came our way. What? Anyway, but we also have to celebrate not just the good things that came to you, but also thank God for the bad things that went another way.
Yeah.
Am I right?
Yeah.
Now, these are the blessings we celebrate. And when you celebrate a blessing, you have to what? Count your blessings.
Yeah.
And see, you have to be vigilant and have a visionary understanding, Commissioner Sutton, about what your blessings are.
Yes,
now, we like to count the blessings that we can see. We are blessed by a bank account. If we're blessed by a new house or a job or a new car. Those are blessings, am I right?
Yes.
We're blessed by nicer clothes and nicer things, but you also have to look closely at your blessings.
Yes.
You see, first, in order to truly understand your blessings that you have, you can't forget the blessings that you did have once upon a time. So if Gary mentioned that when you, if you woke up in your right mind this morning, that's what?
Yeah.
And even if you woke up not in your right mind and had the right medicine to get you in the right mind. Thank you. count your blessings. If you woke up and made out and had all the food that you wanted, but if you had some food that you could eat, that's what? A blessing. And we go back old school, if you woke up and you could go to the bathroom in the house and not outside the house, that's what? A blessing. Sometimes when Zola gone and with my daughter, when I'm at my house by myself, I grew up in a house that had 11 people and no bathroom in it. So when I'm at home by myself, I start in the basement and I go flush the commode and I can thank God for that. Living a house here, I got more bathroom than I got people. Isn't that impressive? It's the little things, right? Now once you count your blessings, you got to do what? Make your blessings count. And most of us, many of us, especially some of the senior citizens here, went to schools where all the books were torn in town.
Yeah.
Went to schools where it was always some other little boy and girl name in your book. Hands off books, am I right? So it's a blessing that our children got new books and new computers. But you know what? Your new book don't do you.